Coming up, I'm going to walk you through the new Azure Event Grid service, which is now generally available. Event Grid is a managed event routing platform which enables you to react in real time to changes happening in Azure resources or your own application. Today, in order to discover a state change in a resource, such as a new database entry or VM creation, we typically perform scheduled or continuous polling. That means that you're continuously consuming CPU and network resources. Using Event Grid, applications can now send events when state changes occur, using push semantics, just like push notifications. Those are only engaged once actionable events are sent. Anyone interested in acting on those events can subscribe and be notified without polling, reducing your required compute resources. Event Grid handles built-in Azure events from Azure services, as well as custom events from your apps, and publishes them in real time. It can dynamically scale to handle millions of events every second, and we offer financially backed 4.9 SLA for your production workload. As events are received, Event Grid facilitates the triggering of programmatic actions via event handlers such as Azure Automation, Event Hubs, Azure Functions, Logic Apps, or custom webhooks. Because everything is based on HTTP, Event Grid can integrate with virtually any service or app. Where this becomes powerful is in simplifying ops and security automation through easier policy enforcement, expanding serverless compute scenarios with new eventing sources, and in enabling better communication and integration between your event-based services and apps. Starting with operations here, you can see that I have a number of event subscriptions set up to trigger programmatic actions for everyday management, so you can automate specific operations and simplify policy enforcement without polling. In the Azure portal, we can write a script for Azure Automation so that anytime a specific event is fired, it will trigger a specific action. In this case, I want to properly tag all new VMs and send a notification to my Teams channel, letting everyone know. I could also do other things like check for open ports or OS version. Every time a VM is spun up, Event Grid will automatically trigger a script checking for these things. Let's go ahead and create a VM to try it out. Now, I already have one set up, so I'll just hit create. Here's what's going on behind the scenes. In this case, we're publishing events from Azure Resource Manager every time a VM is created. When I told the portal to spin up a new VM for me, Azure Resource Manager kicked off a VM create job. Once it finished, it published the event to Event Grid with information about what happened, with what resource, and where. Event Grid looks for all event subscriptions that are filtering to match this set of information and efficiently routes, filters, and delivers it to the subscribing endpoints, in this case, the Azure Automation to trigger the script. So we just got a notification in Microsoft Teams, and if we check it out, we can see that the new VM has been created, which means that the automation script ran, tagged the VM, and notified us that the deployment has happened. I've also sent a copy of the event to a service called RequestBin, where we can see a copy of the raw JSON event. You can see that the event type is Microsoft.resources.resource_write_success, and the subject is the path to the specific virtual machine that was just created. So beyond operations, let me show you how we're expanding serverless and integration scenarios. We now enable serverless applications to react to more events and faster. You can also integrate with your custom applications, all without polling. Here's how it works. Event Grid connects a data source or application to specific event handlers, allowing you to integrate systems and simultaneously trigger serverless functions. In this example, I have an HR application that automatically processes the onboarding of new employees. Here, back in Azure, you can see the event subscriptions I've created in order to trigger actions such as equipment orders, like business card orders and ordering a laptop, payroll updates, and welcome emails. We can also add filters to make sure this only happens when an employee is added and not when one leaves. So what happens is, every time I enter a new employee record, we will order them business cards, add them to our payroll database, and then send them a welcome email. I have a simple console app here running our HR application. And as you can see, the app uses our SDK to publish a custom event to Event Grid when a new employee is added. And if we go back to the portal, you'll see that the event is being sent to three places. The first part of our system is our serverless function. When triggered by Event Grid, it will add equipment orders to a queue to let our operations department know that we need to order new business cards and a laptop for our new hire. Next, Event Grid will send that event to Azure Relay, which will act as our webhook endpoint, allowing us to access our on-prem employee database so we can add our new employee to payroll without punching holes in our firewall. Finally, we have our Logic app, which is simply going to send a welcome email to our new employee. If we open up our on-prem event handler and run our HR application, we can see the new employee hire event instantly gets fired off to Event Grid and received by our on-prem handler to be added to the payroll database. At the same time, we can open up our function log and see that the function has also received the event and added an equipment order to the queue. Finally, if we switch over to Outlook, we can see that we've been sent an email welcoming us to Contoso. Again, all of this has been accomplished with zero polling. So that was a quick overview of Event Grid. You'll see us deliver many more event publishers and handlers, including Azure Active Directory, Azure Container Registry, and more. Azure Event Grid has a pay-per-event pricing model, so you only pay for what you use. And to help you get started quickly, the first 100,000 operations per month are free, and 60 cents per million operations after that. Also, you can take advantage of our management and runtime SDKs to publish and subscribe to events and learn more by trying our quick starts. Thank you for watching.